It has a guaranteed acceptance.
There's so much, I have so many hadiths about the methods of durood, how to read durood. But one thing I will tell you, just one thing about the durood upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. The benefit of durood upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam is that it is always accepted. It's never rejected. Other acts of worship may be rejected, but this will never be rejected. And another benefit of durood upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is that you get what you want without even asking. Without even asking why? Remember, you know, in Pakistan, in the third world countries, when you go there, you get some beggars who will beg from you. On the streets, they will say, you will look at their state. They may have dust on their clothes. They may be poor people. They may be disabled people. You look at them, they will say, so and so, please give me this. Please give me this. Please give me this. Yeah. If they keep asking for what they want, even though you can look at their state and you know they are poor people, a person will look at their state. The signs of poverty will be obvious. You will see them. So what they do is, they go to the people, they stop people, they hold people, they start begging people, give me this, give me that, give me that. And they irritate people. That is a stupid beggar. That is a stupid beggar. He doesn't know how to beg. Then you get some other beggars who are wise beggars. They're beggars of wisdom. They have a lot of wisdom. Intelligent beggars. What do they do? They will give you dua. They'll say, may Allah give long life to your children. Is your father alive? He's passed away. I make dua for your father. May Allah forgive your father. May Allah give you this. May Allah give you that. They don't ask for things. They just start giving you duas. And they're dressed up in such a way. When you look at their parents, that you know that they are poor people. So out of your generosity, you will say, he doesn't ask me for anything. You know his state. You're looking at his state. He's not asking you for anything. He's not begging you for anything. He's just saying, oh Allah, give him this. Oh Allah, give him that. Oh Allah, then he's just giving duas. He's giving duas. Oh Allah, may his children have a long life. Oh Allah, may his father have a long life. Oh Allah, may his mother have a long life. So, you're looking at his state and you know he's a needy person by apparently looking at him. But you will say, he's a needy person, but he's still not asking for himself. He's asking for my beloveds. He's asking for those that I love. I might as well give him something. You'll probably give him more than the one who is begging directly. Why? Because he's a wise beggar. In the same way, a lot of us, when we make dua, astaghfirullah, Allah forgive me, Allah forgive me, Allah give me wealth, Allah give me money, Allah give me dawlat, Allah give me this, Allah give me that. We keep begging Allah Jalla wa Ala, we keep asking for ourselves. The wise beggar is the one, oh Allah bless your beloved, oh Allah bless your beloved. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim. Allah Jalla wa Ala, we look at your state. He is needy of things, but he's not asking me anything for himself. He is still giving duas to my beloved. He wants good for my beloved. He is not asking for himself, even though Allah knows better than the wealthy person in Pakistan and India and Bangladesh, in these countries, who looks at the apparent state of poverty and he will say, look at his clothes. He's a needy person. Allah Jalla wa Ala knows the secrets of our hearts. We don't even have to ask him. What do we do? You say, oh Allah, bless your beloved. Oh Allah, send durood upon your beloved. And I want the darajat of your beloved to increase. You're doing duas for the beloved of Allah. Allah Jalla wa Ala will say, he needs my help, but he doesn't ask me. He's asking for my beloved. I will even give him that which he didn't ask. That is the benefit of durood. Do you see? So durood is an ibadat of a wise beggar.